I'm about to relax my hair. Can't walk around like this no more.
Your girl is about to relax her hair. Like, on days that I don't want to braid my hair down to wear my wigs, like, it's not working. Like, I took my hair down to wash it and I didn't get around to it. And I just can't. Like, I'm so over it. It doesn't matter if I'm natural. It doesn't matter if I'm relaxed. Like, I'm gonna always have a whole bunch of hair. Y'all seen me cut my hair off to like this, and y'all see how it didn't grew back. Like, it's crazy. Like, I'm over it. I already told y'all I really wasn't trying to go natural, but it didn't make sense for me to keep putting relaxers in my hair because, you know, I was always having to braid it up. But I want to braid my hair in peace, you know. It's just like, and this is, and I just did this right here to show y'all like what my hair does when it get wet. Like, I wet it and put some conditioner on it, and this is the curl that I will get. But I'm not interested. I'm not interested, girl. No. Got me a relaxer. And I'm about to straighten this out a little bit. So look, listen, y'all. They ain't give me no gloves. They don't give gloves no more. I ain't got relaxed in so long. Oh, okay. Here we go. Remember how they used to give you gloves? I still give you gloves. I'm kind of saying. There we go. I'm mixing it up, y'all. Oh, I need to get a comb, don't I? Whip it, whip it. Yes, honey, yeah. So look, listen, y'all. While I relax my hair, let me tell y'all a story about your girl. I got fired from my job. This job I always wanted. I got fired. And it was some bull. I don't know what to say about it. I just really just can't believe it. Like, I'm still shell shocked. Yeah, it was all of one of my patients that I went to go see. I'm gonna cut the story. I ain't gonna make it long because I don't even care no more. I'm basically gonna tell you, he was one of these people that was just down on his luck and his health and thought he could talk to you any kind of way. And he was making demands that I wasn't comfortable with doing. Like, he wanted me to shave his skin and stuff like that. I'm like, I don't feel comfortable doing it, you know. And then one of the nurses, I'm skipping over the story, gonna tell the story to my boss saying, yeah, that's what he wanted. Me and another nurse did it. Well, that's you and another nurse. I didn't feel comfortable doing. So basically at the end of the day, y'all, he was mad because I wanted to get help. And he's a big man. He was paralyzed. Like, he couldn't move, couldn't help do anything. You know what I'm saying? So I wasn't finna struggle and do that by myself. Because he kept questioning why you need help, you don't need her. And, you know, he's just very demanding. He told me maybe two or three times that I'm a customer, you're gonna do what I want. You know, and he didn't even say it as nice as I'm saying it to you all. I really wasn't paying that no mind, y'all. Because in the nursing field, y'all, I've been dogged out. Since working with Hope, I've been called slave. I've been called a big nigger, monkey, all kind of stuff. That don't bother me. I don't care. That don't bother me. But my thing is, y'all, I try my best to get his needs met. But because he was who he is and he thought he could talk to me any kind of way, and because I refused to do something he wanted me to do that I felt I wasn't comfortable doing, it pissed him off. So he told his story and they chose to just basically believe him, girl. At one while it came out talking about I was yelling and screaming up and down the hallway like, why would I be doing that? Like, I ain't into it. No employees, no one in that building. Like, it was a patient. So, like, anyway, it's always a bunch of lies when you get into some type of trouble or whatever. No one never really wants to tell the truth. No one really wants to have your back in the situation. Prior to me even meeting a guy, I had two people from the company telling me that he was something else, you know, whatever. So I was going in with that, you know, trying to be careful on how I handled this man. And yeah, she was basically, Charnell, we gotta let you go. Because mind you, I just got kicked out of a building 2 weeks prior to this because a girl asked me, was my job hiring? I told her, yeah. And the director of nursing there got mad and called my boss and was basically, I guess, trying to say we're trying to steal code. I don't know, it's a bunch of dumb stuff that is just so petty and stupid. So she was like, my boss was basically like, Charnell, yeah, my camera just fell again. I don't know why I keep sitting up here. I don't know why I just won't put it on a tripod. But anyway, she was like, basically, Charnell, you just got kicked out of a whole nother building. Now this one, I don't have nowhere to put you. We're going to have to let you go. So I'm just like, well, okay. I'm making a long story short. So, you know, mind you, you talk to people in the company, they be talking all they trash. But every time they get in front of her, it's always something totally different. So I had made a statement. I was like, okay, well, can I come back? And she was like, yeah. Then she was like, well, I don't even know why I told you, yeah. I don't think we ever hired anyone back. And I'm like, really? And the girl that was standing there was doing like this. And I'm like, wow. She just told me a story how she had got two people hired back. Like, one thing about me, I always try to keep it real. I always try to tell the truth, even if it's going to incriminate myself. And in this situation, I had one incident when I first started that I felt like I passed the test. I almost got fired, but I ended up keeping my job. But this time, I wasn't going to try to fight and defend myself against a whole lie. Not this time, because that last time, it just would have put me in a position I knew I would have regretted, you know, if I had try to beat up the one girl that was lying and doing all this lying on me. Like, I just knew I couldn't win, so that's why I didn't really try to fight the case. But I did ask my boss to go back and, you know, ask, can you roll this camera back? Because I want to know who said I was yelling up and down the hallway. Like, I'm a grown-ass woman. Like, why would I be doing it? I know what I have in this company. You know, I got bills to pay. Like, I'm not going to jeopardize my job for doing something stupid like that. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I never really had nobody to fight for me or whatever. So, make a long story short, she ended up firing me. You know, she wasn't mean about it. You know, she showed compassion and she was like, Charnell, if you need me, I'll help you. Meaning, like, she knew other people to give me hard or whatever. And, yeah, so, like, I remember when I first started with the company, I had got trained in the area that I was going to be working or whatever, and they decided to take one of the girl's daughter got fired. They decided to take me off what I was used to and put me on her assignment. And, you know, I was scared. I was fresh. I was new. Y'all know my nerves bad. I hate driving, you know, so I'm getting used to all of this, and I finally got used to doing this, and now y'all gonna take me away. And, hold on. So yeah, y'all gonna take me away and, you know, put me over here now and, you know, X, Y, and Z. You know, I was just feeling some type of way. So, but mind you, the whole time, the girl was calling me on the phone, telling me they can't do you nothing. Dang, shut up. Telling me they can't do you like that. Don't let them do that. She was like, F them and all of this stuff like that. And she was like, all you got to do is just, now I'm new in the company, so I'm thinking, you know, she knows she talking about, I'm thinking I got the power to tell these people, you know, no, I don't want to do it. I want to stay where I'm at. So, you know, all this was taking place. And she called me. I was in the building that I got kicked out of, the first building. I was over there. She kept calling my phone or whatever and was like, you don't have to take that from them. Don't let them do you like that. You don't have to do it if you don't want to. So I'm like, okay. She been working with these people for 11 years. So I'm like, I'll just tell the girl that, you know, I really don't want to do it. I don't feel comfortable. So I'm thinking I'm doing something. But in the meantime, I'm basically effing myself with no grease, not knowing she was an evil person for real, y'all. And so we end up meeting up at this one client house, and next thing I know, they was talking about taking my tablet and stuff, and I'm like, why? But behind, I'm like, I ain't doing anything. Why is this happening to me? You know, I just started or whatever. And she was like, she didn't know. So I thought maybe it was something with the girl that worked at the front desk. Like, I did something to her. I called, I apologized to her. I'm like, what did I do? No one was giving me answers. But come to find out later on, it was the girl that was telling me, don't let them do you X, Y, and Z and stuff. It was her all along. And girl, she had talked so bad about the owner. You know, I kept saying, before we got, because the owner was on the phone, the boss was on the phone, I kept saying, you throw me on the bus, you the one told me don't do it. And every time the girl, when I went to the office, when they changed my schedule, every time the girl that worked the front desk would leave or turn her head, she'd be doing like this. You know, doing stuff like that. So I'm like, I'm still at this point, like, okay, so I don't gotta take it. If I don't have to take it, and if I can stay comfortable where I'm at, then that's, I'm gonna change the name. I was like, Megan, I really don't wanna do it. I'm comfortable. This is where I've been training at for last week or whatever. And you know, that was it. I got the schedule, and you know, I went on about my business. And I know they come back in office, and then my boss was trying to fire me, and I'm like, what the freak for? What I do? And so she was like, you yelling at her? I'm like, she the one was yelling at me. But come to find out, she was only yelling at me and over talking me because she was afraid that I was gonna repeat some stuff that she told me about our boss or whatever. And so it was just a messed up situation. But in that situation, I feel like I won that test because it was a test that I could never pass, you know, because I was really angry and I really wanted to just, well, anyway. Yeah, I just feel like it was a test that I had passed and I was able to keep my job or whatever, you know. And she was just real fake. Like, to this day, you know, I was cordial with her because I had to work with her, whatever. You know how people are. Because she was really mad because her baby girl had got fired. Her baby girl's working for the company. She told me how my boss used to, how she the one man. I really don't know who is the boss or who the owner of the company is. But she was like, both of them married, they effing each other, and that's how she got her business. You know, she was telling me all of this stuff. And so our boss kept asking her, should we keep her? And she's sitting there like, no. And I'm looking at her like, you the reason I'm sitting here. You told me not to, you know, take the assignment, that I can do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm freshly new. So it was a lot of drama that I was going through. And to this day, y'all, that still bothers me. Let me get a towel. And to this day, do y'all know that incident still was bothering me? It lingered in my head. Lingered in my head on how she did me, that girl. And so I told y'all all that to say this, like, when this incident happened, I was so easily let go. No matter, you know, I'm telling my story just how it went. You know, he was a straight talking to me bad, belittling me. I didn't even really tell the whole story on everything he was saying because I knew that it wouldn't even matter. You know what I'm saying? So my boss was like, Charnell, we don't have nowhere else to put you. That's only gonna leave you with like one patient. Then I was like, no, it's technically gonna leave me with five. You know, I can just build myself back up, you know. And so, but I still walked away with no job. All I know is that this was a great company that I worked for. I never worked for a company. I know I don't want to sound contradicting or whatever because I got fired or whatever, but those people, they really did appreciate, well, my boss, at least. That's all that matters because that's who owned the company, you know, even though some of the coworkers was cool. But I never worked for a company where you had a boss that generally, for real, straight up appreciate you. Like, she appreciated me and her workers, y'all. I'm telling, this lady is A1. Like, I can't explain it. Yeah, she fired me, but she still was A1. And I really have so much respect for her. And like, I actually started looking up to her. That's how she the reason I started doing what I'm doing behind the scenes over here, y'all, because I really looked up to her and I wanted to be that type of boss, even though I wouldn't be in the same field. But if I ever had workers, like, I want them to be appreciated. I've been in this nursing homes and stuff, they don't even appreciate you, girl. You work for them overtime, double shift, 16 hours, just working hard. They show no appreciation, but she did. And I really, really, I'm getting emotional, but I really did appreciate her, y'all. She really helped me. It was some things that she was doing. I'm really not upset because sometimes people come in your life for a season, and she did a lot of things, y'all, that she don't even know, that just helped me make it through life and stuff. And I believe God played a part and he used her. It was, y'all, just, I can't even tell the story right, y'all, because I don't even want to get emotional. But she the reason, like, I got this house. She the reason that I'm back on track for his insurance for my car. Like, it's just extra and incentive. How you say that word? Incentive. I don't know how to say that word, but yeah, girl. But anyway, so I'm jobless right now. This is day number 2 that I've been jobless. I'm going to take, oh, look at that, y'all. But look at my real hair. It grew back so fast. It ain't long like it was, y'all, but it grew back. I'm just going to take the rest of this week off and try to get out there because, y'all, when I say I'm smack dab in the middle of a breakthrough for us being what I want, doing what I want in life, I am. And losing my job just hurt me. Y'all, my rent $13.45. Yeah, I'm going to put it on out there. Like, I can't afford not to have no freaking job and my daughter won't have no roof over her head. Like, it's just crazy, y'all. And then it was this one nurse. That's why I don't deal with a lot of people. People in life is so fake. When I walked in, y'all, she was just treating me all nasty with the cold shoulder or whatever. Let me tell you about this too. I could be wrong, but I thought she went and told my boss that I was doing some yelling or whatever. And my boss said it wasn't her. But my thing is, the way she was treating me, like, what I did got to do with you? You know what I'm saying? For you to mistreat me. Our boss didn't even mistreat me in this situation. She just kept saying, Shona, I hate to do this or whatever, whatever. My boss called her back in her to tell the story. Made it seem like whatever I was refusing to do, I could have did it because she did it. You know what I'm saying? Okay, you have. But you felt comfortable shaving skin, not me, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, was treating me all nasty. I was like, see, that's why I don't deal with people. You know, I don't deal with people like that because I hate fake people. I hate fake people. Just like the girl I was telling you about with the incident that was lying on me. She had told me on the phone. She called me. I was sitting at my computer desk and she called me and was like, she was like, that B talked to my daughter foul. I'm giving y'all all these instances to tell you how the people in the office are, but I know they don't want to lose their job, so they not finna go against our boss. But I had two incidents where they told me one thing, but when they got in front of her, it was something totally different. Like the girl saying that they never rehired nobody back, but you and the other girl just told me yesterday, prior to them beginning father, that y'all brought two girls back. But anyway, that's neither here or there. She was like, she talked to my daughter foul. She was like, girl, F them. F them. She just kept stressing F them, and she did. And she just telling me all this stuff about my boss, right? But get in front of my boss and say, oh, I don't want to say her name. Let me think of a name for my boss. Lauren. Lauren is a real cool boss, and I will never work for nobody but her. She's never yelled at nobody. She's never this, and she's always there. And I'm looking at her like, really? Y'all know I recorded some of this stuff that I'm talking about. Like, I don't think I would ever, you know, use it, but I got proof because, like, my boss didn't want to hear nothing I had to say that day. Nothing. That girl was the reason I was there sitting in the office. I recorded her saying a lot of stuff about her having sex with the man, our other boss there. I don't know who the boss, but I know Lauren signed my checks. Well, signed my checks. So, but anyway, yeah, I got her recording saying a lot of stuff, but it didn't even matter because I felt like I won because I still had my job. I had a good relationship with my boss. My coworkers was really cool. And, you know, I was doing okay. So, because God handled things like that. And God gonna handle this situation too, you know. So, I'm not even worried about it, you know. Now, had I not been in the middle of a breakthrough for what I'm trying to do in life, I would have been, I cried, but I'm saying I would have probably broke down and just lost it. But I know I have, I've made a lot of major steps towards my business. And so, yeah, I still would have been working at Hope. I would have made it to my 2-year mark before I was able to walk away from my 9-to-5. You know, so, because you know, you have to use wisdom. You have to be smart. Just because I started a business don't mean I could just walk away from my 9-to-5. So, which means I would at least made it to my 2-year mark before I even started thinking about leaving. You know, so it probably would have been 2.5 years that I had, you know, worked for Hope or whatever. But yeah, like I said, I really love her. Like, she is the, you know what, she was a real cool boss. Like, when I say my whole work and my whole entire working experience, I've never had a boss like her. And she's a bomb. But anyway, I ain't talking about nothing, y'all. I really ain't. So, your girl sitting here nappy-headed and jobless. I don't have a job. My rent, $13.45. So, I got to figure this out real quick. You know what I'm saying? But God got me. He said he will provide. He will supply all of my needs, you know? So every time I try to do right, the harder I try, the more it seemed like I'm getting pushed back. Let me tell y'all this. I had just told some people in the company. I just talked to them the 2 days prior, like how I do everything in my power not to, you know, upset my boss and try to do everything right, and then the next day I get fired. Like, I should have never just spoke those words out of my mouth. Like, I shouldn't have, because I got fired the next day. I was like, because she has been so good to me. I don't know, y'all. I just don't know. Y'all, he was talking to me foul, you know. But in my mind, I kept saying, I'm not going to be in here long. Once I'm gone, I'm gone. I can always go back to them and tell them I just can't with him. He is treating me X, Y, and Z. And, you know, not saying they would have did anything about it. I don't know. But that was my mindset at the time, you know. He was like, you shut up and you listen to me. Don't you cut me off. I had cut him off while he was talking. You know how when someone talking and you start talking. Girl, I said something while he was talking. And, ooh, Yeah, he was talking to me real bad. But that's okay. Because you know what, God? Look at him. Just look at him. Not trying to be mean. So, you know, I'm just going to pray for him. Because that's what I was taught. You pray for those that despitefully use you. And so, that's just what I'm going to do. And that's what I did in that first incident. When I first started working for the company. When that girl did me like that. And I did just that. And when I say the company, oh my God. Yeah, I just don't know. But anyway, I've been doing good. I have been thriving. And yeah, so with that being said, my job came into play right when I was losing my husband or whatever. Oh yeah, yeah, my divorce is final. If y'all want me to do a whole video on that, let me know. Comment below. Comment below. Yes, my divorce is final. It was final April 26, 2019. So yeah, my job came into play today when I was in a very low place, and like things was just looking up for me. I just don't understand, you know, and I'm not blaming God, because I know you didn't bring me somewhere, bring me this far to, you know, no. I know God has a hand in this somewhere, and which means I just need to work harder behind the scenes on what I'm doing or whatever. I still got to go get a job or whatever. I just know that people can ruin your life if you let them. That's just all I know, and I'm good. I don't even care no more, I swear, you know. I just don't care anymore. I'm just going to do me. I'm going to live my life. Love on my babies. My grandbaby. My sons. And Gail. And my friends. Since I've been working for this company, you know, I haven't been supportive to my friends and stuff. They call me every day like, sis, what's up? Where you been? When you heard from you? So, you know, because I was so dedicated. And, yeah, I'm just going to get back to doing me. You know, I'm going to get back to everything. Anything that you might not think that matter. Back to wearing makeup, lashes, you know, just petty stuff. I'm just going to get back to life. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, see, I'm relaxing my hair. I'm getting back. You know, I'm going to just do me. Yeah, I'll be okay, you know. I'm going to suck this up, take this L, and just move on with life. You know, I hate it, you know, because I saw longevity for me in there. Even if I had a did my business, because it's always good to have multiple streams of income. So if I even had been doing good and start booming in my business, I could see myself even making it to, would have made it to the third year, you know. But y'all know my ultimate goal was to be my own boss. Y'all know that's my ultimate goal. But you know, I was just going to be smart. You know what I'm saying? But yeah. So, but anyway, Rhea, I ain't really talking about nothing, y'all. I'm going to go ahead and relax this hair. Y'all, look how much it has grown. It hasn't even been a year since I cut my hair, my relaxed ends. Y'all saw how long my hair was. It's almost, when I cut my hair, I was up under here. And now I'm here. Hair, I mean, that doesn't even matter to me. It grows. So, if I cut it off, I actually started to cut it off bald this morning. For real. I ain't going to even lie. Try to get these edges to grow on back in. They trying, y'all. Yeah. So, but anyway, yeah, I ain't talking about nothing, y'all. I don't really too much come on here. I share with y'all what I share, but I try not to put too much out there. But, hey. So, I'm going to listen to my music, y'all. And I'll just see y'all when I turn this camera back on. But I will tell y'all that one jar only did almost half this. And I might be doing it wrong. But, I don't care. I just needed to get straight. So, yeah, I'll see y'all when I turn this camera back on. So hey y'all, I'm back on y'all screen. Girl, look, listen, I'm done putting this relaxer in my hair, but look at this side, it's still curly. I did the same thing to this side that I did in the other parts of the relaxer. Like, I don't know. And the back, look at the back, y'all see the curls just still there. I'm just gonna wash it out now. So okay y'all, I am done. I got all the conditioner out. I have blow dried this mess of a hair, honey. Yes, it's all done. Now I just gotta figure out what to do with it. I don't know if y'all can see it, but this is the back of it. And yeah. And look how much hair came back. Yeah, so anyway, I'm gonna think a little bit more, y'all, see what I'm gonna do with this. And yeah, I'll just see y'all when I turn this camera back on. So yeah, I've decided to go ahead and style my hair. Now y'all, I ain't no hairstylist or nothing like that, but I am sensitive about my. So I got my hair sectioned into three. I'm going to braid these down. I don't know what I'm doing, but I'll show y'all. So yeah, y'all, I got my hair all dried up. It was still kind of wet right here in the middle. So look, listen, let me tell you something, ma'am. This is not no tutorial. I'm just doing my hair. It's just like, it's a video. It's a vlog of me doing my hair. You know what I'm saying? So, and then I'm going to put a little eco gel on it. Not on the edge part, but kind of like right above it. Not in the front, just around to the back. See, y'all can't see it, but like I said, this ain't no tutorial. I'm just doing my hair on cam. It's already waving back up, so hold on, let's hurry up. And your goal is to try to get this as smooth as possible. So this part of it really don't have to be all that neat, because this is basically building the canvas to what the next step is after this. But you do want it nice and tight, and you do want this to be nice and neat. But the braid don't have to be all that. Okay, I came back and told y'all I made a mistake. I shouldn't have put nothing on there, judging how this one is braiding and how it's looking. So I didn't put too much on there. I did put a little bit of edge control right there, but I didn't put it all the way down like I did the other one. So y'all, I am all braided. This is what it's looking like. I don't know if y'all can see it back there in the back, but I got my little braids. But that's how it's looking in the back. I don't know what them parts looking back like there. I don't know, but ain't no edges right here. But we gonna try to hide that when we get to the next step. So let me show y'all. Girl, Chanel, you look bald head. So I'm gonna go ahead and use my grease real quick. I'm going to oil my scalp a little bit. Look at my hand. Kind of rub it on the braids. I'm old school, babe. We used to use grease. We ain't know nothing about no argan oil, olive oil, coconut oil, and all that old oil. We ain't know nothing about that, girl. So the next step, you need some type of braiding hair. In my case, I need three bags because I got three braids. And you're gonna need a needle and thread. Those are the next two steps and you'll be done. So hey y'all, hey, I'm back, girl. So look, listen, I can't find my wig head stand, you know, the one that you put on the table, to do this myself. So Princess and I has a pencil, and we're gonna wrap this hair around and we're gonna braid it. So we're gonna wrap this around here. Come on, I'm not going to braid it too tight, because at the end of the day, you got to go in and loosen it up anyway. So I suggest don't even start out. No, don't listen to me, because I don't know what I'm talking about. Because most people braid it and then they go in and loosen the hair up. I'm going to proceed to braid this all the way down. I don't know why it's messing up on me, but it is. Y'all still can see. I'm just going to take this and we just going to braid it. So I'm gonna go ahead and start loosening this up now, so I don't have to worry about it. And this is what you should do too if you're gonna be doing this. And the reason you don't want to braid it too loose, because you run the risk of it being too loose and coming loose. So you do kind of want to tighten it and then go back and loosen it up. But again, like I said, this ain't no tutorial.
Tutorial.
I'm just trying to do my hair and go in here and cook this spaghetti real quick.
We have a spaghetti, I forgot.
You did? Well, I mean, you still probably should eat something, because it's going to take a minute before I cook it.
Yeah, I'm just going to wait. I'm going to wait.
We're going to go ahead and start. I'm not going to prolong this. Let me kind of put this chair down so y'all can see me. Can y'all see me? Yeah. And you want to go ahead and stick this where you're going to put it, because it'll stay in place while you're starting to sew. That way you don't have to worry about sewing it and holding the braid. So you see that? I got it down. I should bring it up some more. I am. It might not be cute, but my hair done. And like I said, people usually only do this with one or two, but I always got to be different. Well, I don't know why I always got to be different. So I'm just gonna sew it, and you kind of want to sew on the underside and not do what I just did. Okay, y'all, I got sidetracked because we about to have a tornado, so I had to turn the TV up. Mama, turn the TV down a little bit so they can hear me. So, I'm basically just sewing the braid that I braided onto my own hair. And as you can see right here, that's my hair, but I'm sewing it onto their hair. And, yeah. And that's just basically it. I need to fix the front part because I start sewing really, really fast. And, yeah. See, the front didn't turn out right because I didn't know which way to turn the braid when I first braided it. Hello, Stitch. If it don't work, I'll just take it out.
What about
the spaghetti? I'm gonna make the spaghetti, Mama. I'm almost done.
Hey, camera. Hey, kids. Hey. Mm-hmm. I haven't said that in a long time.
No, you haven't. I'm trying to get this together, Mama. Let me do this.
Cute.
Is it cute? Yay! Princess approved.
Yep, approved. The edges are cute. The braided hair is cute.
Oh, that's what you eat. Did they stale?
No.
I'm doing it all wrong, y'all, because I'm supposed to go under where you're not supposed to see the thread, but I don't care. So, okay, y'all, I am done with the hairstyle. This is it. And that's the back. You can turn it like it's supposed to, but guess what? My hair done. So, look at this. I'm about to go wash my hands. And we're going to go in here in the kitchen. And we're going to make us some spaghetti. Let's see what the weather is talking about. Hold on. St. Louis City, tornado watch. St. Louis County. Okay, let me just go on in the kitchen. I'm just washing my hands. Oh my God, it tastes so good. When you don't have everything to go in your meats and stuff, when you cooking and you doing stuff from scratch, it tastes so good. Yeah, I got to hurry up. It's getting close. It's like 10 minutes away from me, they saying. But nothing has touched the ground here yet. Y'all, look what it's looking like. It's about to do something out here. I'm finna take me some of that meat out and eat it just like that. It tastes so good. I am not lying, y'all. I cannot make it up. Oh, man. Sure hope this vlog end well because I'm gonna be in the basement with Princess. She already in the basement, y'all. She funny. Put this in the microwave. So if the lights go out, we have some cooked.
Now here into North St. Louis County, running right along the Missouri River.
It's right
and
by me.
This is the area, and you can really see kind of a wedge shape to that cloud. You guys were talking about reports of a funnel cloud with this system coming out of St. Charles County.
Oh God, please, and let it just bounce right over us. Let it bounce over everyone, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Those tornado warning signs. We're going around a big curve here, trying to
look at the cloud.
We are now approaching Lindbergh here, 270. We have just come out. I'm going to go back to our the rear of our view here in our vehicle. We were in absolutely blinding rain right after we showed you that look off of St. Charles Rock Road. That cell kind of overtook us, and absolutely zero visibility for a while. And now this is the scene just to our west.
Ooh,
and
look
to
at
our
that.
Northwest now. And again, taking my earpiece out here momentarily, I can hear the siren sounding here in North St. Louis County. Again, we are right at Lindbergh and 270. We've now driven
right by me.
And this is the cell that we're watching so closely. Moved through St. Charles County, and now
we're y'all come up here and watch my back, at least so I can know when to run downstairs. I want to cook as long as I can. I'm scared. It's right at 270 and Lindbergh, y'all. I don't know what that means, but anyway, I ain't talking about nothing. I'll see y'all when I turn this camera back on.
Come here, baby.
And here comes the rain.
I'm glad I'm not crying. I'm a strong little lady. That's why my name is Superman, Supergirl.
Why is it flooding right there?
Let there be rain.
Okay, y'all. Got my meat done. The spaghetti is going. Should be almost done. And I got my cauliflower and hamburger meat with onions. It's good. So good.
So good. Okay, y'all. I ain't really talking about nothing, y'all. Y'all know. Wash my hair. I relax my hair. I call myself trying to comb it. I didn't cook dinner. And that's all I got, y'all. So I ain't really talking about nothing. I'm gonna hurry up and get this spaghetti done. I'll see y'all when I turn this camera back on. Okay, y'all, I made it. The spaghetti is now done. Nothing else has been served with this, but dinner is now served. Anyway, it just hit something. Your TV went out, Princess?
Yeah.
Princess TV just went out and the internet just went out. Oh, we didn't get scared. At least the lights are still on, Lord. Let there be lights. We cannot afford to let these lights go out. Kay Andre? KK, come and eat something, baby. So, I don't know what we're going to have to do. But, everything is out. So, anyway, yeah. That's it, y'all. I ain't talking about nothing. Okay, so, therefore, I'll see y'all when I turn this camera back on. So, until next time. Until the next video. Bye-bye. Hey.